Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Art with Mrs. Smith. Today we're talking about famous artist Vincent van Gogh. That's right, we're going all the way back to 1853 when he was born in the Netherlands and didn't create his first painting until he was 27 years old. Unfortunately, he died 10 years later. In that 10-year span, he made 900 paintings and only sold one. His most famous piece of art is this, Starry Night. I think everyone has seen a version of Starry Night. It's beautiful, the rhythm and movement that's going on in the picture, the impressionistic look, which is those short strokes that are bold and very colorful. And we're going to recreate that in our own version where we kind of mimic the master here, and we're going to create our own Starry Night version with a skyline, if you will, that'll be in the front. So we're going to do that. So we're going to refer to pages 18 and 19 in our handouts. Okay, so we have a little history and then we have the information on this project. So what we're going to need to get started is, of course, pencil and eraser, our sketchbook to produce our rough draft. And remember, this project, we want to do one complete, really tight rough draft. And we went over what that means, but we'll go over it again in just a minute. But you'll need your sketchbook, pencil, and eraser for the actual project. You will need your oil pastels and some napkins, okay? Or if you have baby wipes, that's great, but if not, napkins are fine. And then you will be using the dull side of your poster board. That's really important. So dull side of the poster board. So let's get started on mimicking Van Gogh. Let's just go over a little bit more information on what we know about Van Gogh. As I said, he didn't make his first painting until he was 27. He wanted to be a pastor, just like his dad for a while. He was always giving to the poor, and when he started painting, he had to use peasants for models because he couldn't afford to pay them. And that's why we'll see a lot of self-portraits of himself as well, just because of the same reason with money. So he was 27 when he did his first painting. And he was very, very close friends with his brother, Theo. He wrote over 800 letters to his brother in his lifetime. And his brother actually passed away 6 months after Van Gogh did. And it was Theo's wife that collected all of Van Gogh's paintings. And it was her mission then to have the whole world see the talent of Van Gogh. So other things that happened, you may have heard about the whole ear incident, okay, where he chopped off part of his ear, and it all had to do with a girl. Can you imagine? So there is truth to the story. A little bit of the ear was cut off, and it was, again, his tortured life that he had. He was in an insane asylum for part of his life, and that is where he actually painted the very famous Starry Night picture, from an insane asylum. So his very last picture that he did was called Wheatfield with Crows. And I'd like you to take a look at it in the bell work that I gave you. At the very end, it is featured, and you get that ominous look in that painting. So you'll see what I'm talking about. So we're going to recreate his style, appreciate his art, and we're going to create our own masterpiece. So let's get started. Okay, let's take a look at our handouts to see where we should get started. We have our sample here of Starry Night. We have some of his other paintings, and then we also have our directions here. So we're going to come up with one tight rough draft. Remember, the tight rough draft means it's very detailed. And we're going to take a look at the directions. We read about Vincent van Gogh. We're going to pick a skyline. It doesn't have to be one that is on this handout. You can make up your own futuristic one, or you can look up another city that you're fond of and do that as your skyline. But to get started, we're going to put our paper horizontally in landscape mode. And it says to position your paper horizontally, draw your skyline in the bottom third of your page. So if I were to break up this page into thirds, all right, this would be the bottom third of my page. So I could just lightly put a horizon line at the bottom, and that's where I'm going to start making my skyline. If you're not sure exactly where to get started, take a look at the silhouettes here, and that will really help you out. So you can see the buildings, and you can go ahead and go in and start making those buildings. take a look at your handout for whatever city you want to do and get your buildings. And it's important that you leave a lot of sky area so that you can do this beautiful sky that Vincent van Gogh did in Starry Night. So I'm going to vary the heights of my buildings. So I might have some that are lower, higher. I might have some mountains that are in the background that I want to get. And then I can have some what are called like landmarks. Okay, so if I did want to do the Eiffel Tower or something like that, I could do that. And then you're going to get all of that put in and then go ahead for your sky. You're actually going to draw that out. So get your moon in there. Look how I'm drawing like a letter C first with a smaller C inside, okay, to get that crescent moon. And actually go in and kind of do the flow of the sky to get that rhythm and movement going. Okay, so that you're gonna get that. If you wanna put little areas for stars, you can. But go ahead and get all of your foreground, your sky, and if you do want any landscape as far as mountains and trees, things like that in your picture. So go ahead and make that a really tight, rough draft. This is what a tight, rough draft would look like to turn in. So I have gone with an Asian theme on this. And I have some pagodas, a bridge, some other yard art over here, and some other buildings, and just some iconic looking Asian art that is in there. A little Japanese cherry blossom tree that's getting into the picture over here. And I still have left plenty of room for my swirly sky that's going to go in there. So you want lots of those swirl elements, not just one giant swirl, okay? So get that all done, and then you're going to go ahead and get that turned in to me so I can give you feedback and give you a thumbs up to get started on the final. For the final, I have my rough draft here, and I want to go ahead and get it done on the dull side. Remember, we're going to keep it dull and get that dull side face up and start drawing on there. So you're just going to draw lightly. Don't worry if you have a lot of eraser marks because the oil pastels will cover that. So you're gonna go ahead and get your image transferred onto this board from your rough draft. So luckily, that's almost like a map, a floor plan. You have exactly what you need to do, and you can go ahead and get started on getting that roughly put in place, and then you can go in and do a few other details. But remember, you don't want anything too detailed or ornate. Because take a look at your oil pastels. They're not like a crayon with a tip. They're pretty dull. So you're going to just be able to use that. So you don't want to be able to have anything too intricate there. So go ahead and start getting this drawn out on your board. Okay, follow your rough draft that you did. And then as soon as that is on the board, there's no need to outline with a Sharpie or anything. We'll get started right away on the oil pastels. Okay, I've transferred my art onto the large, dull side of the board, right? And I'm ready to start using my oil pastels. I have some baby wipes handy here, but if that doesn't work or if I don't have those, I'm going to go ahead and wet some Kleenex or some napkins. And then I can use that, so make sure you look at your oil pastels first and clean off the ends of them because you don't want there to be red on there or something and get red where you don't want it. So you can see how well just water and napkins work. Okay, so now I'm going to start with my sky first, all right? I'm not going to put any black on my board yet because black is so messy, and I'm not going to put the yellow yet, all right? But I'm going to go ahead and work with the blues and the white to get the sky going. So when I do this, I want to do those short little strokes. So I'm using my oil pastels in short little strokes and filling a lot of the page. Like I said, they're more like an expensive crayon. So short little strokes like the impressionistic style. And then I'm going to go ahead and get another color in there as well in the white areas that I left. And get that all filled in. Okay, so you really want to fill up a lot of your page. I'm going to go back in, put some blue in there. So once I've laid down a couple of little sections, then I'll go back in and blend, because blending is a really important part of using your oil pastels. and get that nice smooth flow there. All right, so I've got that. I'm gonna go back to the other color now. Get some of the blue in there. All right, I'm gonna do my whole sky first. All right. Okay, so now you can see that I've laid down quite a bit. So I'm gonna go in and start blending that. So you're gonna be using your fingers, and that's why we have our wipes, you know, handy. But you end up using each finger, which is kind of cool, so you can keep working. And you wanna blend in the same direction that you drew. So you don't wanna just start going like this all of a sudden. It's really important that you blend in that same direction that you drew. And let it flow around. Then you start to see that rhythm and movement that we saw in the Van Gogh painting. All right, so I'm getting this around, and you see how that's just nicely blending right now. So you can always go back in and add a little bit more, but it fills the whole page right now, so I don't have to go back in. I can add some little details, but I don't have any white showing. I can add white afterwards to get more detail, which I probably will do. When you go to do the buildings, let's just go over this right now. I don't want you to use straight up black. This is called a silhouette here when you just see the black, but I'd like you to combine other colors. So please don't do all of your buildings in a solid black color. You want to add several different colors, okay? You could use browns and greens, anything to get that really dark color area, but blend it a little bit because you want this to look like it has a little bit of depth to it. And if I get both colors in there, I can blend, you know, a little bit. So go ahead and do that. Don't use solid black. Remember, don't do that. So I'm gonna finish my sky and then move on. I've left all my areas open for the stars right now. So what I wanna do is go back in. I'm gonna clean off my white pastel here really good, because I don't want to get blue in those stars. And I'm going to lay down some yellow, and I'll get that in there real good. I can mix it with a little bit of white or orange if I want it to be a little bit of a more intense yellow. All right, so I've got my yellow, and I'm going to lay that down in all of these middle areas that I left open for the stars. Okay, and now I can go back in and blend those just a little bit. Remember, I do not want to get a green color going in the sky. So I'm just going to blend just a little bit with my fingers. And then I can go back in and add some of those lines around the star and just ever so lightly blend. Okay, again, you can use orange if you want to. You can use some white in there as well. Then you can see how I'm doing that a little bit more. If you want to add any other areas, you could put down some white first. Maybe make a really good circle of white. And you can wait for that to dry just a little bit, and then you can add some orange or yellow to that and see how that blends out for you. Get some orange in there a little bit, and then maybe a little bit of yellow in there as well, and just kind of blend it out a little and get some white, you know, that circular pattern going around the stars. And that just gives it that little bit of motion look around there, all around. Then you can go back in and finish off the bottom of your picture. And then, like I said, go back in, and if you want to add a few more little strokes of movement in there to look like it's swirling around, you can do that with white and black afterwards to get some more detail. Okay, as you can see, I've gone in and blended everything, added some more details with white around my swirly areas, gone in and put some black outlines to make things stand out, and everything is blended. So you're supposed to have a painted look with this. So don't worry if some of the areas look like they're a little fuzzy or maybe not in focus. This is the look for oil pastels. I can't wait to see what you show me.